Hi, young children, welcome back. Hope you have practiced all the topics what we have explained in our previous class. Now we will see some more topics on decimals in this video. We'll see here conversion of a decimal fraction into a fractional number. Decimal fraction into a fractional number. We will discuss here about the working rule for the conversion of a decimal fraction into a fraction number. The rules of converting decimal number to fraction are: write the given number leaving out the decimal point in the numerator. You have to write by removing the point, total number you have to write together as your numerator. Write a 1 in the denominator followed by as many zeros as the decimal places. Then write the resulting fraction in the lowest form. We'll see one example here. Convert 1.5 to fraction. We have to convert 1.5 to fraction. How we are going to convert? To convert 1.5 into fractional number, first we need to write the numerator 15 leaving out the decimal point and then write 10 in the denominator. Since after the decimal point here, we have only one number. So 15 by 10. Now we can simplify it by 15 by 10 and its lowest form by dividing it by 5. 5 3 is a 15, 5 2 is a 10. So our lowest term is 3 by 2. Means what is our answer here? 1.5 we have to convert into a fraction. For converting that into a fraction number, just write this 15 together as the numerator. Don't write any point in between them. We have to leave point and write together. Now this point we will write as 1 in the denominator and count how many digits are there after point. Only one digit. So write simply a 10 here. Only single zero we have to write in the denominator. Now we can divide 15 and 10 in the same table. Which is the table? 5 table. So 5 3 is a 15 and 5 2 is a 10. What is the lowest fraction here now? 3 by 2 is our lowest fraction. One more example, convert 21.72 to fraction. We have to convert that into a fraction. To convert 21.72 into fractional number, first we need to write in the numerator 2172 leaving without decimal point and then write 100 in the denominator. Since after the decimal point there is 20, two numbers. So this will be our fraction. Now we have to form this into our lowest form. So these two numbers can be divided in which table? 4 table. So numerator and denominator should be divided with 4. When you are dividing it by 4, your number will be 543 divided by 25. What is our question here? 21.72 or 72 hundredths, right? Now how we are going to write? Just write all the numbers together in the numerator, that is 2172. Now divide it by this point will be taken as 1 in the denominator. Now count how many digits are there after point. 2 digits are there. So write 2 digits in the denominator. This is our fraction. Now we have to convert this into lowest fraction. This can be divided with the 4 table. It will be 25 and it will become 543. This is our lowest fraction. This is our lowest fraction. This is how we are going to convert a number into fraction and then to its lowest form. convert 54.9722 to fraction. So how to convert this? What is our question? It is 54.972. As I told you in before examples, remove point and write total number as our numerator. What is our total number? It is 54,972. That should be divided by this point. We will be writing as 1. Now count how many digits are there after point. How many are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 digits are there. So write 3 zeros in the denominator. 0, 0, 0. This is our fraction number. Now, if you observe, the same number is written here. These are fraction number and we have to convert this into its lowest term. For converting this into its lowest term, we have to divide. First, we have to check in which table we can divide these numbers. So, here we can divide these two numbers with the number 4. When you are dividing these two numbers with the number 4 in the numerator and denominator, we will be getting our final answer as 13,743 divided by 25. This is how we are going to convert our decimal numbers to fractions and fractions to its lowest terms. Now we will see what are equivalent decimals. Equivalent decimals. Some decimals such as 0.1 and 0.10 have the same value. How? We will see by observing this picture. Here, if you observe, these are how many blocks? Nana, it is 10 blocks. So, one block is shaded with blue. That is 0.1, we can tell. 1/10. If you observe the next picture, here one block is totally colored with blue, but the total blocks here are 100 blocks. So we'll write in the decimal form, that is 0.10 or 10 hundredths. We will be reading them. These decimals are 0.1 and 0.10 are equal. How you are telling these are equal? Because if we put 0 after 1, the value of the number 1 will not change. Look at the equal decimals now, 0.1 and 0.10. The only difference is the 0 on the right. 0 on the right. You can add zeros to the right of a decimal number without changing its value. Will not change any value. We'll just simply put a 0 after 1 so that these two numbers will become equivalent decimal. When you are writing any zeros towards right side, the value does not change the number's value. So 0.1 and 0.10 are both are equal decimals. Now we'll see some examples here. Let us consider the following examples. 0.4, 0.400, 0.400, 0.4000. If you observe here, 0.4 is common in all the numbers. But only number of zeros are extending towards right. So, each of the above is equal to 0.4 only or 4 by 10. Now, second one, 1.9, 1.90, 1.900, 1.9000. Here also if you observe, 1.9 is common in all the numbers. Only the zeros are varying in the numbers. Now it is equal to 1.9 or 19 by 10. This is how we are going to write our equivalent decimals. If you come to the last one, it is 10.14, 10.140, 10.1400, 10.1400. Here 10.14 is common in all the numbers. 10.14 is common in all the numbers. So our fraction will be 1014 divided by 100, or 10.14 is the common decimal numbers. So these are all equal decimals only. Similarly, we have 0.300 is equal to 0.30, that is equal to 0.3. In the same way, the next two also will be having the same value. 0.200 is equal to 0.2 only. Thus, by adding any number of zeros after the extreme right digit in the decimal part of the decimal number does not change the value of the number. Numbers obtained by inserting zeros after the extreme right digit in the decimal part of a decimal number also known as equivalent decimals. Hence 0.75, 0.750, 0.75 00 etc. are equivalent decimals. You just observe only the digits after the decimal, whether they are equal or not. No need to consider zeros as the values, because zeros doesn't have any values. Consider only the number of digits after the decimal point, and then only you have to identify whether the given decimals are equivalent or not. Now we are going to see like decimal fractions. Like decimal fractions. Two or more decimal fractions are called like decimals if they have equal number of decimal places. However, the number of digits in the integral part does not matter. In like decimals, we will be consider only the decimal part. We will not consider about our whole number part, that is integral part. We'll just see only the total number of digits after the point are equal or not. Let us consider some of the examples. Here if you observe 1.12, 0.45, 15.65 and 110.01. If you observe here, after point, how many digits are there? After point, in all the numbers, you are having only two digits, right? So these are called like decimal fractions. Like decimal fractions, because they are having only two decimal places. Now we'll see the next example. Here after point, only one digit is there. One digit, and one digit. Here these are also like fractions, because after point we are having only one decimal place value. Now we are going to see unlike decimal fractions. Two or more decimal fractions are called unlike decimals if they have unequal number of decimal places. Now, we will not consider our integral part, Nana. We will not consider our whole number part. We will be considering only our decimal part. After point, if number of digits are equal, they are called like decimals. If they are not equal, they are called unlike decimals. Now, we will see some examples regarding this. Here, if you observe, after point, how many digits are there? You just count and write. So, how many are there? Here it is 1. Here it is 2 and here it is 3 digits are there. After the point, you are having 1 digit, 2 digits and 3 digits. If you observe here, after decimal point, we are having different decimal points. That's why these are called unlike decimals. In the second example also, after point 2 digits and after point 3 digits. So these are also called unlike decimal fractions. Children, just observe these two images. If you observe this, you can find the difference between like decimals and unlike decimals. You have to put the decimal point equally for all the numbers. Then you have to identify the digits after the decimal point. Here after decimal you are having only single digit, right? Here after decimal point you are having two digits for every number. That's why these two groups are known as like decimals. Now coming to unlike decimals, after point if you observe, here you are having two digits, here you are having single digit, here you are having three digits. So the number of digits after decimal points are not equal. That's why we call them as unlike decimals. Now changing unlike to like decimal. How to change unlike to like decimals? We will see now. Unlike decimal fractions can be changed to like decimals by adding as many zeros as required. I told you before only, if you are going to write zeros after the last digit, the value does not change. The value remains the same because the value of zero is nothing. Suppose, let us take decimal numbers 14.3, 8.14 and 7.195. If you see here, we have only one decimal place here, and here we are having for the second one two decimal places, but for the third one we are having three decimal places. Now how we are going to change this to like decimal? If other decimals are also changed into equivalent decimal with the three decimal places, all of them will become like decimals with the three decimal places. Therefore, what we are having in the first one, we are having only 14.3. For that, we just added two zeros. And second one, we are having 8.14. For that, we have added one zero. Now, what it became after decimal point, we are having three decimal places. Now, these are all equal decimal places. They are called like decimals because we have put zeros after the number. The value does not change by putting the zeros after the number. This is how we are going to change the unlike decimals to like decimals. Hence, we conclude that to find the number of decimal places in the decimal with the largest number of decimal places. For first, how to find whether these are like or unlike, we have to go and identify the largest decimal number. Change the other decimals into their equivalent decimals which have the same number of decimal places as the decimal with the largest number of decimal places. This is how we are going to identify first largest numbers, then put zeros and form all the decimal places into equivalent form. We'll see some examples here. We are going to convert 0.3333 127.01 69.4 into like decimals. If you observe here, which is the largest number here, we are having four decimals to the first number, so it is the largest number. Now what you have to do, you have to observe how many zeros are there after the point in your decimal place values. Here you are having four, here you are having only two, here you are having only one. So we need to put how many zeros here? Here we have to put two zeros and here we have to put three zeros. We have to write two zeros over this number after decimal number, and here three zeros we have to write after decimal number. So what will be our numbers now? Therefore, like decimals are 0.3333, 127.0100. We have just added two digits after the decimal number. Now, for the last one, we have added three decimal zeros. That is three zeros after the decimal number, 0.4000, with four decimal places. Now, these are all like decimals. One more example, see here, 43.04, 94.3, 101.432 convert into like decimals. You just observe which is the largest decimal number. This is our largest number. So how many decimal numbers are there after point? We are having 3 decimal numbers after the point. If you observe how many numbers are here? 2. Here we are having 1. So how many zeros we have to write for the first one? We have to write only 1 zero. For the second one we have to write 2 zeros after the decimal number. Right ma'am? Now what will be our zero? What will be our decimal numbers now? Our decimal numbers are 43.040, 94.300, 101.432 with 3 decimal places. This is our like decimals now. This is how we are going to convert our unlike decimals to like decimals. Just observe this picture here now. 1.7, 2.35, 6.135. If you observe here, you will be finding 3 decimal places here. Here also 3 decimal places. Here also 3 decimal places. After adding zeros, we have added zeros. How many zeros we have added? 2 zeros here, and here we have added 1 zero. Because in our question, the last number is having 3 decimal places. These are unlike, and after converting they became like decimals. Now we will see how to compare decimal fractions. How we are going to compare our decimal numbers. We will discuss here about the comparison of decimal fractions. While comparing natural numbers, we first compare total number of digits in both the numbers. And if they are equal, then we will compare the digit at the extreme left. If they are also equal, then we compare the next digit and so on. We follow the same pattern while comparing the decimals. So, in our normal pattern of ascending and descending orders, how we are going to compare? First, we will compare thousands, hundreds, tens, ones. Right? In the same way, here also we will be comparing the numbers. One by one. We will see some example regarding this. Examples on comparing decimals. Compare 0.6 and 0.8. Now 6 is in tens place, 8 is in tens place. Because 8 tens are greater than 6 tens, 0.8 is greater than 0.6. Because both are in tens place, 8 is more than 6, that's why 0.8 is greater than 0.6. Now compare 0.317 and 0.341. Now how we are going to compare? First expand our decimal numbers. 3 is in tens place, 1 is in hundreds place, 7 is in thousands place. Here also 3 is in tens place, 4 is in hundreds place, 1 is in thousands place. Now here both the tens are equal. Both the tens are equal. 3 tens is equal and 3 tens is equal in the number. Now we have to compare our next digit. What is our next digit? It is hundreds. We have to compare hundreds. Now 1 is less than 4. 100 is less than 400. Now we got the difference here. Now we can directly write the numbers. That is 0.317 is less than 0.341. Because here the hundreds value is less than the other hundreds value. That's why 0.317 is less than 0.341. Steps of comparison of decimal fractions are given below. Step 1. First we need to observe the integral part, that is whole number part. For example, 104 is less than 140. This is how we check the integral part. 153 is equal to 153. 122 is greater than 121. Step 2. Now we compared our integral part. Now we are going to see our tens place also. Now when the integral part is same, then compare the tens place. For example, 1.4 is less than 1.9. Here our integral part is 1 only. That's why we are not checking our integral part. We are checking our decimal part, that is tens place. 1.5 is equal to 1.50. 16.2 is greater than 16.1. This is how we are going to compare our whole number parts and decimal parts. Step 3. When the tens place is same, compare the hundreds place. For example, 10.04 is less than 10.09. 1.97 is equal to 1.97. 71.92 is greater than 72.90, because here the first three numbers are equal. We are comparing the number which is a hundreds place. You just go through this example, the picture what I have given here. If you observe this, you can easily identify the decimal numbers and how to compare the decimal numbers. See the example, 19.023, 19.027. Now first we have to compare our whole number parts, that is our integral part, 19. Both are equal, they are same. Now coming to the tens place, that is also equal. Next hundreds place, that is also equal. Now coming to our thousands place, here it is 3 and here it is 7. 3 is less than 7. That's why 19.023 is less than 19.027. Children, hope you have followed all the topics in this session. Now it is your turn. Practice all the topics and try to complete your exercise. If you have any doubts in your exercise while doing, you can get back to me. Hari Om. Thank you.